Hello, today I will tell you how to paint wave with a lot of foam and with sand in the bottom. So let's start it. I'll tell you what I'm going to use. This is the list of paints. Phthalo green, indigo, gold ochre, ultramarine, permanent red, permanent yellow, burnt umber, greenish blue, titanium white, linen canvas, 40 and 60 centimeters, shadow brushes. At first we take these paints, gold ochre, titanium white, burnt umber and greenish blue. You mix them until you get homogeneous mass. We've made this color to show wet sand in our painting. Afterwards, I prepare a mix of titanium white, greenish blue and phthalo green, perfect for the basic color of our wave. And the darkest color is for background part. You can see this deep water behind the wave. I like to make heavy ground layer and I let it dry for a while. When I don't have time, I use hair dryer. It may be useful in this situation, but as for me, it is more convenient to paint several artworks at the same time. When one artwork is drying, I'm painting another one. Now I'm showing first lines of future wave. I use two color mixes at the moment. The first one is the basic wave mix of titanium white, greenish blue and dull green. The second one is made with the same paints, but I took more greenish blue to make these dark outlines and shadow spot from the wave. I take titanium white, a little bit of permanent yellow and greenish blue. With the help of this color mix, I'm showing how the light shines through the body of the wave. If the paint is wet, you may take for blending clean and dry brush. If it's too dry, it is better to take wet one. Just dip the brush into the water. And if the brush has absorbed more water than you need, just blot it with a piece of cloth or towel. And remember that paper towels aren't suitable. Bits of soggy paper can make your painting look pretty dirty. I'm applying the first layer on lining canvas 40 and 60 cm. I've chosen this shape of canvas because it is the most suitable and popular for landscapes. This line of bright color shows where the wave will be, but it is only the first layer, so I will change the color of it significantly. Now you see how I alternate light and dark tones of paint. This is done to indicate the movement of water. To draw water realistically, imagine the movement of the water. It does not stand still. The forces of the wind lift up a huge layer of water. It rises and then crashes against the shore or water surface, possibly. To recreate the color of the foam, I use a mix of white and burnt umber. I apply the paint, not in a solid line, but in separate splashes. Each splash has a unique character in the painting. You can make it serene or fanciful with additional spray satellites. Each of them is part of the ensemble. Sometimes students don't understand the importance of different layers. I'll try to explain. It's kind of 3D effect in the cinema. You see a lot of layers in one picture, and you see the last layer the most clearly. But underneath you see some parts from the previous colors. So in this way, you create really interesting and voluminous painting. With one of the previous mixes, this is a mix of titanium white, greenish blue and dull green, I'm making semi-round lines. Try to make it not straight, but semi-round. It will help you to make shape of the wave a little bit more realistic. Now I'm showing how the sand is lifted up by the force of the wave. The line is not clear. Borders are erased. Mix of blue, phthalo green and white are good for showing transparency of water and for demonstrating how the water boils and descends. Now please add a small amount of ultramarine to titanium white. To make foam not so bright, you may also add teeny tiny amount of permanent red or burnt umber. Use more ultramarine to make it more dark. Ultramarine, indigo, permanent red and white. The first mix I'm making for the foam is a lot of white, less amount of ultramarine and a little bit of permanent red. The second one mix consists of white, ultramarine, indigo and permanent red. To show the depths of the wave, I've took white, indigo, ultramarine and red. White with a little bit of greenish blue and yellow helps me to show main outlines for the foam that are falling downward. Long-stem brush also can be helpful. I'm slightly showing where the foam on the coast is. To show how the water starts to foam as it rolls down at great speed, let's take blue and greenish blue. Foam begins to break through in different parts of the wave. Its streams have different colors. There are shady areas, there are those where the bright light falls, and sometimes in the shadows we distinguish the volume of flowing streams. So please use different shades to show volume parts. For the most dark parts of the foam, you may add more indigo. For the light parts, more white with small amount of permanent red. And don't forget about ultramarine. Try to make at least 5 shades of one color, from dark to light, and use them for the spot of your painting. mix of greenish blue and indigo. The waveform was previously drawn in a dark color scheme. Now this light, almost white color helps to highlight those areas of foam on which light falls clearly. At the moment I'm making shadow from the wave with the help of tallow green and indigo. I've added also a little bit of raw umber paint. Mix of Aurora Sienna, Titanium White and Raw Umber is good for light areas of the shore. You can see a mix of white, indigo, ultramarine and permanent red. I recommend using it to create color variations. It can also be used to draw foam that rolls down from the inside of the wave. Here you can get by with a few tones. Our foam is conditionally white. The wave is conventionally blue or blue-green. The foam that flows down inside the wave is saturated with the main shade of the wave itself. So in the light part of the foam inside the wave, I add a little, really a little bit of the main color of the wave itself. In this case, as you remember, it is greenish blue. A flat brush is very suitable while working out the background of the painting. At first, give an overall light tone, then work out the details step by step. Now I am applying the shady areas of the sand that are under the foam. The foam also has its light and dark parts. Note which side the light is coming from. This will help you identify the lightest and darkest areas of the picture. Use the principle of contrast when working with a drawing. Somewhere it is appropriate to alternate between warm and cold shades to give expressiveness, somewhere dark and light. They look beautiful and attract attention when a bright accent is made on a rather dark area of the picture, as if light has been shed. I begin to apply light areas of the foam slightly. These areas especially clearly show how the foam falls, what massive and beautiful this element is. You can create the reflection and shine the water in such a simple way. Now I'm adding details. You may notice that at first it's more convenient to work with dark tone. With every layer, paints I use lighter and lighter. Some light spots I may apply at the beginning too, but this is for comparing and creating visual color gradient in the picture. I like details in the painting, also clarity is not always needed. You probably know that there are clear lines in the drawing and there are soft, sometimes even blurry ones. To create a harmonious picture, you need a reference material that you are guided by, or just your experience, feeling, imagination. Sometimes I paint without reference photos, just imagination. In order for harmony to come to such a work on a whim, sometimes you need to close your eyes. And when you open them, you can even take a magnifying glass to draw the details well in some places. Light falls on the foam near the wave. Now I emphasize the light areas. I paint streams of foam on the wave. Please know that they are not perfectly straight. They also consist of multiply streams. On the one hand more, on the other they are less. You can also draw splashes. They will add movement and energy. Now I'm using mix of greenish blue and white with a small amount of permanent red. I'm applying greenish blue paint with light blue, color of clear water in this wave. Greenish blue is transparent paint, and light blue is semi-opaque. When we add enough water or thinner for acrylic paints, I'm using plain water in this case, then through this mix of paints, the light color of the previous paint layer is visible. Using a thin brush, apply the foam details. Here you can let your imagination run wild, subtle lines that create whimsical white lace. Now I go with the tails of my foam that is formed on the top of the wave. Please note that it's not about just applying the brighter shades. I repeat the following steps for each part. Firstly, I apply the lighter shade. Then I do the shading, paying more attention to the edges, and then add more paint over the shaded area. Don't hesitate to repeat this process in all parts of the wave, wherever you think it will bring harmony to your composition. Indigo and phthalo green are great for dark part of the wave. Thank you. after the waves have already been drawn and nothing will change, it's time to put separate splashes. I apply them with almost white paint with a slight admixture of other colors. Now I think the work is finished. Thank you for being here with me. Wish you to have a nice day.